That, to me, is the gutsiest win of the NFL season. Their game on Sunday got flexed to Sunday night. It's a huge divisional showdown against Minnesota. They should never have had to have played that late Sunday game and then the early game on Thursday.
Yep.
But what can you do? That was the schedule. They do it without Maserati Mitch.
That's right.
And they get a win in the division.
You heard it. Maserati Mitch. We didn't stutter. No. You know what? The front office, Greeny, for sure. And you brought this up. They deserve a ton of credit. It starts with the hiring of Matt Nagy. It starts then with Matt going out and constructing a coaching staff that right now is comprised of a bunch of tremendous, tremendous teachers. And when you really focus on the defensive side in particular, the most important thing they did was retain Vic Fangio and make sure that he stayed there, because the players have talked about the fact that they're in a system now that they're very comfortable with, that now they just continue to learn a little bit more and more about it, to the point where they can anticipate the kind of plays like you saw yesterday with Eddie Jackson, which is they're so confident in what their assignment is, they play a step ahead. And what they're doing is not a fluke. I mean, it's a man coverage situation. He talked about, I believe, post-game, the fact that the formation deployment, the way the personnel were deployed, he thought that that was the route he was going to get. That's why he jumped the route as quickly as he did. You saw him do it the week before against Kirk Cousins when he picked him off. He picked off a 7 route and returned it for a touchdown. These are the kind of things that are born out of a coaching staff that right now is hitting on all cylinders. That Ryan Pace, the general manager, has made all the right moves as far as from the top down again of getting Matt into place. Matt has hired tremendous teachers. He now, and then, you know what? There are tremendous coaches who are great on a blackboard or on a grease board when you're in a meeting room, who can tell you, who can draw up all kinds of stuff that'll just blow you away. But then when they kind of get into the live action, Greeny, they shrink. And they almost forget all the things that they taught you. This football team, this coaching staff doesn't do that. All the information that they are giving their players, the players are able to use on game day. When they need to adjust, they adjust. And right now, the team is staying healthy, knock on wood, and they are executing out of their minds right now. I don't think it's a fluke. People will point to their strength of schedule and say, they haven't beaten anybody. No, actually, they beat the Minnesota Vikings, who a lot of people said was a runaway winner of the NFC North.
Sure.
So, look, in 2 weeks, we'll find out, because they're going to play the greatest team of all time, the L.A. Rams, that nobody can stop. Okay, nobody. Sean McVay has reinvented football. Look, I love these guys. I love the Rams. And I'm being facetious, but let's just see what happens then, and then we'll see whether or not all the stuff that we're talking about right now really has some teeth.
Yeah, because the way you beat this high-flying offenses like the Rams, you're not going to hold them to 13 points.
Right.
But your defense forces turnovers.
Right.
And maybe you put the ball in the end zone, which, again, the Bears have done 5 times defensively this season. So they've been spectacular in that regard. I think the acquisition of Khalil Mack, both for what he's done on the field and what it's sort of jolted the franchise,
sure,
that's the best move that was made by any team this
season. Yeah, and look, I didn't even mention that part of it, because it's almost like – it's almost like gravy on the top of, you know, a tremendous dinner already. I mean, he's like the cherry on top, and he's an all pro, maybe an MVP candidate.
I think for this holiday, gravy was the
gravy was perfect
analogy.